Welcome to Tops and Bottoms, episode number 6. This is the show where we take a topic presented from one of us or the community, and we break it down and talk about it. Who's the top? The top today, I'm going to say, is Kevin, because you presented it, this specific topic to us. Yeah. So you can go ahead and present your topic to us.
I talked about, it's always something that's kind of been on my mind as far as like gaming. Recently, I've been playing games that have been a little bit more difficult, but I think for the most part,
dubstep
games as of recently have become a lot like more like just a lot easier. And I think like a lot of games have been like simplified from like from one entry of the franchise to like another entry. They've become like more like simplified, progressively, like, you know, easier.
Hand holding,
hand holding just to appeal to like a broader audience. And I thought that'd be kind of like a
press X okay. to do things.
Exactly.
Do you have a specific example of that
you can think of right now? I think like right now, like a lot of like the Call of Duties. Hmm. Like I know, like I just finished playing Call of Duty 4, the remastered edition. And I played it on hard, and I was like, fuck, like, this is a fucking hard game.
So, like, I guess it's, like, quality, or, like, the way the game's designed. Sometimes games, they just mount on the difficulty by just adding extra enemies or putting a higher health meter on an enemy. That's just, it seems very boring and very lazy.
Fake difficulty.
Yeah.
Fake, yeah.
But let's fake say news. Games, I hate to use an example because I feel it's used a lot, but like something like Dark Souls, just like the way enemies are placed, like there's traps or you have to learn certain boss like
movements.
Patterns.
That seems like, yeah, like real difficulty.
Yeah, it seems like it's more
organic,
thoughtfully designed.
Instead of just like, you know, having to like...
More shit!
Yeah,
more of the same.
Call of Duty is, I guess, a pretty good example of that, where they're like, you know, like the veteran difficulty is like fucking...
Yeah.
They just throw more grenades at you and they're like 100% accurate, and then like it's like 10 million of them more.
Maybe like the rise of, you know, video game easiness is maybe it was a business decision.
Yeah.
You know, maybe game companies figured, oh, if we make the games more accessible, we'll make more money.
Yeah.
You know, because I feel that those older games that were harder, they were intended to be challenging.
Yeah.
You know,
uh-huh.
Especially for Japanese games, like those fucking Japanese people, they like a good challenge. Have you heard the whole deal about Super Mario Brothers 2? Like,
yeah,
they,
Doki Doki Panic.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Like they made that in America, Super Mario Brothers 2, because the real Super Mario Brothers 2 was too hard for us.
Yeah.
Which is, they released it eventually over here as the Lost Levels.
Yeah.
That was the real Super Mario Brothers 2, and they didn't release it until later because it was just too hard for American audiences.
For dirty casuals.
Uh-huh. Yeah, man.
Exactly. That's kind of the whole like point of it. Like, you know, it's kind of like the, just, you know, making it easy. Just, I mean, I know like I know why they're doing it, because they want to like Dead Space. The first one was like, you know, very like, you know, relied a lot on like survival horror and stuff, and then as like the other ones kind of progressed,
like the Resident Evil problem,
exactly, yeah, and they just, it just like, we gotta appeal to a broader audience, and I guess that's kind of another subject altogether.
There's a thing that I don't really like in difficulty in video games, that a good example is Resident Evil 4, where if you, it's kind of a way to like kind of give you like a, it holds your hand, because if you die a certain amount of times in a specific level and you spawn and you go into this like the same room, for example, there's like maybe like one or two less enemies.
Really?
Oh.
Yeah, Resident Evil 4 does that, where it's like if it kind of start analyzes how like you're dying, so let's help you out here.
Yeah, like almost, it seems almost like condescending.
Yeah, because
you know,
like,
it's like, oh, we're not gonna let you try to get better. We're gonna make this easier.
Exactly,
for you.
And like that's
fuck you,
that's
dude.
Something I at least like doubled down in that, because that I mean, that kind of, I didn't like that, because I'm like, man, I know I'm bad, but let me do it.
Yeah, exactly. And then you compare it to fucking like Donkey Kong Country, where you die like at the same place like 10 different times.
Yeah.
They don't change it for you. You just gotta get good.
It's a lot more rewarding.
Or hoarding.
Yes,
rewarding.
You know, like a good example of a modern game that has reasonable difficulty, I think, is Doom.
I was about to mention Doom.
Yeah, Doom is like a great, like, it has a great like learning curve. And, like reasonable, but like challenging difficulty.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And I love that, you know, like it doesn't hold back.
Yeah,
you really do have to get good at that game
get
to beat
good.
It.
Does it have different difficulties?
Yeah,
it does. I just played it on normal and it was pretty hard.
I played it on hard, and there was some points where I was like, "Fuck, like this is difficult."
Yeah,
I got like really like frustrated at some points.
Yeah,
but I mean, it was still, but nonetheless, it was like, it was satisfying after like
very rewarding.
The cool thing about Doom is that like it progressively gets harder too. Like even if you're on a normal difficulty, like it starts out really easily.
Like I said, it's a good curve.
Yeah, you're like one-shotting mobs, and then like, you get different certain enemies that require a little bit more either strategy or just you're going to put more bullets into them.
That's right. That's right.
Do you guys think difficulty is a thing that you can that can be implemented from like different games as multiplayer? Like, because I feel like Overwatch versus like CS:GO, I feel like those games are. I feel like Overwatch is a little bit an easier first-person shooter to get like a grasp of than Counter-Strike, where you have to really be kind of exact with your shots and.
Yeah.
Like with there's champs in Overwatch where you just have to like aim at in the general direction you'll hit something.
I think for multiplayer the difficulty depends on who you're playing with.
Okay.
You know, like maybe like the game is designed to be easier, but like you're always gonna get a different challenge every time if you're playing with certain people. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, but I think some games are just inherent, like you said, like you know some games are just inherently easier to pick up.
Yeah.
Like a game like Gears of War is fucking hard to pick. Like really? I like.
If you want to be competitive.
Yeah like multiplayer. Right, yeah. Like I remember, like I got into that, and I was like, "Fuck, dude! Like this game is like,
yeah.
If you're not good at that game, you like
you get punished.
Don't even
bad.
Work. Yeah. Like, don't even like, don't even get into it."
Yeah, because I feel like nowadays I think that's where games are kind of going towards is multiplayer.
Yeah.
Like Battlefront didn't even have a campaign. Like Battlefront. So yeah. That game is really just that its difficulty is based on your skill and the people you play against.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Is difficulty in video games something you look into when you're trying to find a video game to play?
Not really. Most of the time, not.
Yeah, like in terms of purchasing a game, like difficulty is not something I look for, but I appreciate it when a game is challenging.
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. I agree. Yeah.
I think you would be disappointed though if like you buy a game you're excited for and you start playing and you're like,
that's really easy. Really?
That's how I felt with the recent Deus Ex game.
Really?
Because I feel like the first one was
Deus Ex.
Yeah, Deus Ex. I feel like the first one is a pretty challenging game. I'm talking about the Human Revolution.
Yeah.
And then I beat Mankind Divided, and I was like, man, I was like, that was just. I mean, I think I played it on hard too, and it was just like.
Have you been feeling recently like games are just like for you like they've been missing that difficulty?
Yeah.
I mean, you give that example of Mankind Divided.
Just because like I'm not. I mean, like I said, I'm not. I mean, the greatest. Like it usually takes me a couple tries if there's a really hard boss or level. So I mean, I still find games challenging and enjoyable at their current difficulty level. So I mean, I really haven't felt that unless I'm playing a specific game that's kind of easier. But
Mario.
Those games
are hand-holdy as fuck.
I also play a lot
What about Mario Maker?
No, that one's a little more like user input.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fucks with you.
I tend to play a lot more of. Multiplayer games, so
yeah.
I've recently.
So there's a variety of challenge in multiplayer.
Yeah, yeah. There's
because you're always fresh. It's always fresh for you.
And on my end, it's always shitty teammates. It's never me.
Follow me.
It's always. I'm just bad at multiplayer.
Yeah.
Games.
No. What about you? Any example?
I don't think. I think it's an exaggeration that just like people are saying like games are too easy now. No. Remember back in my day,
because they're playing on the easiest difficulty.
There you go.
Well, that or like maybe they're not like sometimes there's games you could play it a certain way where it makes it more difficult.
Mm-hmm.
I mean maybe that's
like a Nuzlocke run.
Yeah.
Oh, Pokemon.
Yeah, pretty much. Or like because I remember reading about someone who was playing BioShock the first one without killing anyone or something like that.
Oh, Jesus.
So it was
that
like,
seems like it's
fuck. Weird. Yeah. So it was like
self-imposed challenges.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true. Because in Dishonored, you can pretty much make a run where you don't like touch anybody.
Yeah.
Except I mean, I think there's specific characters you have to kill, but you can do that
because
you get different outcomes.
Zelda no shield run.
Jesus.
Hit everything back at the sword.
Yeah. Kevin, any games that you... Any examples, I guess, that you...
I actually have an example.
Not really. I don't know. What do you got?
Pokemon, dude. Mm. Like, Pokemon nowadays is way easier than before.
Yeah, that's a good example, too. Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And just playing it normal... Like, playing it how I usually play Pokemon, you know, like, in like, the original Red version, usually, like, before the first gym, I would just grind all my Pokemon to, like, high levels, and... The game was still challenging.
Mm-hmm.
You know, once you get to the Elite Four, it's still, like, a great challenge.
Yeah.
And I don't know what they did. It was just, like, a good balancing of, like, the enemy levels. But nowadays...
And you like...
You just decimate everybody, like, in the single player.
Yeah.
So I don't know what happened there, but I'm not a fan. I like my Pokemon games to be hard.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But Sun and Moon, I'll give it to Sun and Moon. The last person you fight, pretty fucking hard.
Yeah.
Brilliant AI
that.
On that.
Play that one.
Oh, it's a good game.
Yeah.
If you think difficulty should be ramped up or ramped down, let us know in the comments down below. And if you want to submit a topic, leave that also in the comments down below. Or tweet at us using the hashtag tops and bottoms. And
that's right.
Twitter page is, of course, as always, twitter.com/JohnBrookBoard.
And while you're at it, follow our, or like our Facebook page, facebook.com/numberboard, and follow our individual Twitter pages. And I'm at The Great Migs, and these assets has have still not made Twitter pages. One day, maybe.
Shame them, shame them.
One day.
I'll never join you.
Joke on them. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we will catch you guys on the next video.
Kisses.